Hello students, welcome to explore mechanical engineering with Saqib Nasir. Today we are going to start our first lecture which is about fluid dynamics. Our course title is fluid mechanics. So first of all I would like to explain fluid mechanics. So first of all you should know about the fluid. Anything that can flow is called a fluid. Fluid basically is a comprehensive term which encompasses the two things which are the liquids and the gas. So instead we call this is a liquid and or this is a gas, or instead of calling the air is passing on any structure, we collectively we prefer to say just the fluid is passing. We would move toward the mechanics. Mechanics means anything, the study of science, the study of fluids at rest or motion. So basically it contains two branches of science. The first one is the static, in which we study the object in at rest position, and the second one are the motion, in which we study the bodies in the in motion, in a state of motion. So comprehensively, if we define the fluid mechanics in one single definition, we can anything that can flow, and we want to study this in state of rest as well as in motion. So I hope you got the point. If we have a water in a glass, and in the second scenario, if we have moving water in a canal, so in both scenarios, the first one in which we have water in our glass, we would call it as a fluid static. And when we study in term of subject point of view, we would call it as a fluid static. And when we talk about the flowing water within the canal, we would prefer to say it is a fluid dynamics. It is a fluid dynamic because it is in a dynamic condition. The fluid is moving within the canal. So in this scenario, we would prefer to say the fluid dynamics. When we combine these two scenarios, then we call it as a fluid mechanics. I hope you got the point. So let's start the chapter, which is introduction and the basic concepts. I would read it for all of you. So during the reading, I would try to explain all the difficult terms which you don't understand about the fluid dynamics step by step. So let me start. In this introductory chapter, we present the basic concept commonly used in the analysis of fluid flow. I hope you got the point. We would start our introductory chapter from the fluid flow analysis. So what is the fluid flow? Basically, I'm talking about fluid dynamics, not I'm talking about the fluid statics. So basically, we start this chapter with the discussion of the phase of matter. As we know, the state of matter, there are three states of matter. The first one, basically it's a two. The first one is solid and second one is fluids. And in fluids, when someone is talking about fluid, it means it is understood whether he is talking about a liquid or a fluid or a gases. So during the whole course, when I would talk about the fluid flow, then it would be understood that whether I'm talking about a liquid or a gaseous flow. So we start this chapter with a discussion on the phase of the matter. So phase of the matter, it's mean that we are talking about gas or liquid. And numerous way of classification of the fluid flow, such as the viscous versus inviscid region of flow. So what is viscous and inviscid region of flow? So let me start this topic by explaining these two terms which you would encounter during the whole journey of this course. The first one is viscous. Viscous means any flow which have changing viscosity during the flow, means it has viscous effects. So in this it means if the fluid is not changing its viscosity during the flow, it means it is an inviscid flow. Internal versus external flow. If we have internal flow, it means we are talking about the flow through a closed channel or closed pipe. And external flow, it means we are talking about the flow flowing over a structure. Just like if I think you all have the idea about the wind turbine. In wind turbine, the three blades are externally come in contact with the incoming air. I hope you got the point. You are getting the point. Similarly, compressible and incompressible. This term is basically related to the changing in density. So later on, I will explain what is the density and what is the viscosity physically. We would consider at that time at least 2 to 3 examples during the discussion. The first one, but no, I am trying to simplify the concept which we are going to study during the chapter. The first one we would study the viscous and inviscid region of flow. The second one we would study internal versus external flow, compressible versus incompressible flow, laminar versus turbulent flow, natural versus forced flow, and the steady versus unsteady flow. We also, these terms, I think you all would be blank about these terms. You don't even have an idea about these terms. So it's my duty to clarify these concepts to you. So please be patient. I would explain these terms when we start this chapter in a regular manner. So we also discuss the no slip condition. So what is the no slip condition? You just keep in mind that the term no slip condition, basically it's a boundary condition. So what does meaning of no slip condition? I will explain I will explain this concept on later on. At fluid solid interface and present a brief history for the development of fluid mechanics. So all these things we are going to discuss in fluid mechanics. First of all, we would discuss the history about the fluid dynamics. Then we would further move toward the fluid interaction with the solid structure at the boundaries, where we define a no slip boundary condition. When we look toward the state of the fluid, whether it is a static or it is moving over a structure, so then we are interested to check the nature of flow, whether it is moving within the closed channel or moving on the externally. So when it is moving, so what type of patterns it is following for the streamlines, whether it is a streamline flow or it is an irregular flow. So all these terms we are going to discuss in this chapter. I hope you got the point. So let's start from the introduction. I have explained you that what is mechanics. Mechanics mean if you want to study a fluid, whether at rest or in motion. For example, you have water in a glass. It is a static fluid. What does it mean? You can question me that it is not a static fluid, because when we look into a glass of water, there is always motion of particle within a glass of water. Then why am I saying it a static fluid? In fluid dynamics, if I would say any fluid a static fluid, it means that it has no head. So shocking, what term I am saying, what is head? Please be patient, I will explain that later on. Head mean, collectively you can say that head mean the sum of energy at a particular location. If a fluid would have energy, whether it is form of velocity or it is form of pressure or it is form of height, and collectively we would call it as a head. So for the sake of simplicity, when I would call as head, it means that I am talking about just height difference. If a water don't have a height difference, it means that we would say it is at static. On a micro level, every particle is moving within this glass of water. But when we talk about when we differentiate between static and dynamic fluid, then we are talking about the head. If a fluid have head, it means it has higher difference in height. First of all, for example, if we have water at this height and the second container we have at this height, got the point? So water will automatically starting moving from higher level to lower level. Within this channel, I would call this fluid as a dynamic fluid because it has head. It has head of energy. So that's why I am saying this is a dynamic fluid. And when it has no head, then we would say it as a static fluid. Mechanics is the oldest physical science that deals with both stationary and moving bodies under the influence of force. The branch of mechanics that deals with the bodies at rest is called statics, while the branch deals with the bodies in motion called dynamics. I hope you got the point. The subcategory fluid mechanics is defined as the science that deals with the behavior of fluids at rest, fluid static or in motion. I hope you got the point because we have generated a lot of discussion in this lecture. So what is the physical meaning of dynamics and what is the physical meaning of static? You can't say that you have any technology to ultimately take the fluid at rest. You can't even supposed to do that because it's a natural phenomena. There is a vibration and there is a translation. It's a natural phenomena of the fluid particles. You can't say that any fluid particle can come to at rest at any temperature. But why I'm calling this is a static fluid? Because it has no head of energy, because it is in a closed container. It is placed in a closed container and it is not moving from one place to another place. If fluid is moving from one place to another place in a collective way, when bunch of particle is moving from one place to another place, then we would call it as a dynamics. So why I am giving so much stress on this concept? Because this is the basic concept of fluid dynamics. For example, when you start preparing a building, if you don't spend too much money and too much effort on making the base of that building, you can't even imagine to complete this construction successfully. Your building has a weak base. Similarly, if you would prefer to spend your energy instead of clearing your concept, you prefer to put all your energy to memorize these concepts in the form of rata, then I think your base would remain weak. So you can't think that you could be a good engineer or you could be a good fluid engineer. So you should spend a lot of time in clearing your basic concept. So that's why I'm putting too much stress in clearing this these two concepts. It's the simple things. These are very, very basic concept and very easy concept. The if you spend your all efforts, I'm sure this would be your life's one time effort. And then in the next time, when you open your book of fluid mechanics, I don't think you put a lot of energy to clear again this concept. And when you would prefer to memorize these concepts without getting any understanding, on every time you would spend equal effort when you come across these topics. And this is the final experience that I am sharing with you. So please put all of your efforts in clearing concept. Stay away from rata. Okay? So come to the point. Fluid mechanics itself is also divided into several categories. The study of the motion of fluid that are practically impossible, such as liquid, especially water, and gases at low speed, is usually referred to as hydromechanics. When we are talking about water or gas at low speed, then it is called hydromechanics. A subcategory of hydromechanics is hydraulics, which deal with the liquid flows in pipe and open channel. And what is the gas dynamics? Deal with the flow of fluid that undergoes significant density changes, such as flow of gases through nozzle at high speed. Later on, I will discuss these concepts. So, gas dynamics, particularly, we would not discuss about the gas dynamics because it is beyond the scope of your curriculum set by UET. So, we would not discuss about the gas dynamics. We would prefer to discuss just hydraulics in this course in a little manner. I don't think in FM1 we would discuss this hydraulics in FM2, because the same book would be recommended for these, for both of the courses, FM1 and FM2. So that's why the author is trying to mention this subject at this early stage. So I hope you got the point. And the third category is the aerodynamics, which deal with the flow of gases over a body, such as especially air over bodies such as aircraft, rocket, and automobiles at high or low speed. Some other specialized categories, such as meteorology, oceanography, and hydrology, deal with naturally occurring flows. So what is flow? Anything that can flow is called fluid. It encompasses basically two things, which is liquid and the gases. Look at this figure. In this figure, you can see that we have two plates just beneath and above this fluid chunk. Basically, the author has been placed not a fluid chunk, it is talking about the rubber chunk for the sake of understanding at this stage. If you put force on the upper plate, suppose that this rubber chunk is fixed, is completely stick with upper and lower plate. This lower plate is at rest, and the upper plate you are moving with the force F. So what would happen with this rubber structure? Yes, it would be deformed in a shape like this, as you can see in this figure. So it would move by making the angle alpha with respect to the initial state. So what is the shear stress? Here you can see that it has been written tau is equal to F over A. What is the shear stress? In mechanics of material, you would differentiate the stress components It's the normal stress and the shear stress. And in fluids, you're just talking about the shear stress. Why? Please, the same answer. Please be patient. We will discuss. We would create a lot of discussion on this figure. You just try to understand this concept. Why this author is saying this force in the form of shear stress? Because it is exerted on this rubber chunk in parallel direction. If I would exert this force in a normal direction, then I can't say it as a shear stress. We would call it as a normal stress. Very good. Normal stress. Normal mean when a force exerted on a body at a right angle, mean making an angle 90 degree, it would definitely increase the length, longitudinal stress, or it would press the thing perpendicularly. It is a compressible stress. Suppose this is a surface and I would exert a force in parallel manner, then I would say it as a shear stress. That's why he is writing a shear stress and eliminating the effect of normal stress, because the force is exerting in parallel direction and it is exerted on the contact area. You are not interested about the whole area of the rubber chunk. You are just talking about the contact area. So what is the scenario of the whole diagram? You have taken a rubber chunk, you put force on the upper plate. This force generated a shear stress. This shear stress ultimately deform a body. One thing you must keep in mind, the shear stress will deform a body. When I rub my hand over to the other hand, it would definitely deform my upper surface of my hand. When we elongate a body or compress a body, it would increase in its length or decrease in its length. So that's why the author is writing deformed rubber, not he is writing as a elongated rubber, because we are putting a force in a parallel manner. I hope you got the point. Let's move on to the other figure. Here you can see that this is a surface area and we have just focused on this small area and it is denoted by dA. And the normal component, when a force applied on any angle at this area, it has two components. The first one is normal component and second one is the tangential or parallel component. So I would recommend, please guess which force is going to contribute in making the shear stress. Yes, very good. It's a tangential stress, because we have defined that the parallel force exerted on any area would deform that area, and it is called the shear stress. And the force which elongate or compress any fluid chunk or any solid structure in fluid, in the whole course we would not talk about the solid structure, but for the sake of understanding I am talking about solid structure. And in this figure, why author is talking about rubber? Just for the sake of understanding. Because from the second chapter to onward at the till last of the book, he would talk about just fluids. Whether it is understood I am talking about the liquid or gases. So that's why don't be confused that with this concept by thinking in this way that we are studying a fluid dynamics and the author is talking about the rubber. Rubber is a solid structure and we are studying the fluid structure. Why he is mentioning such type of example over here? Just for the sake of understanding. from the second chapter, he would just focus on your fluid structure. I hope you got this figure, you got the idea of figure. So we have two containers. The first one, in the first one we have gaseous molecule, and in the second one we have liquid molecules. So the properties of gases and liquids you have studied a lot, so I'm not going to discuss over here. It's your assignment to clarify these concepts. So application of fluid mechanics. So what we have studied so far, I'm going to repeat all concepts. First one, I'm trying to share your trailer of this book, of this chapter. Initially, the author said that he would focus on inviscid and viscous flows. Further, he mentioned that he would focus on internal and external flow, compressible or incompressible flow, steady or unsteady flow. Secondly, he moved further to discuss about the branches of fluid mechanics, whether we are talking about the fluid at rest, fluid statics, or fluid at motion, fluid dynamics. Then the further he extended his discussion by saying that just gas dynamics, hydraulics or aerodynamics, all are the sub branches of fluid dynamics. Okay, then he moved on the defining the fluid, anything that can flow. It comprises two things. The first one is liquid, the second one is gases. So how fluid is going to deform? In such a way like a deformed rubber. And it would be our basic assumption during the whole course that in what fashion the fluid would deform. It would deform just like in a rubber, like a rubber. Okay, and what type of the stresses has its components? The first one is normal component and second one is the parallel component. The first one is normal stress and the second one is shear stress. And at the end we talked about the liquid and gases property. The next lecture we would cover all the applications of the fluid dynamics. I would recommend, and it is my humble request to all of you, please, we have started our fluid mechanics course officially from the introduction. So try to grasp all your concepts physically. Prefer to clear your concept by taking real life example. If I am talking about rubber deformation, then how can I relate this deformation with this small fluid deformation? It's your duty to generate a lot of discussion and to think at that level in which you got the in-depth clarity of all the concepts. So it was your first lecture. In the second lecture we would discuss the application area of the fluid mechanics, and we would discuss about deeply no slip conditions, and at the end brief history of fluid mechanics. So we would cover in the next week. So we just studied a very smallest, a very minor concepts, a very short concepts, just two concepts. We have discussed just two concepts. What is fluid and what is mechanics? What are its branches? What are its types? Okay, so all, it's your duty to clarify all these concepts in detail. In next lecture, I would try to generate discussion from all of you by taking all of you on my live Zoom call, and we would take a small quiz in this short discussion which I have generated, which I am giving to you. So please stay tuned with my channel, and for getting more videos, please subscribe my channel. And in order to get all the new videos related to your lecture or related to your future discussion, whether it would be related to scholarships or it would be related to your future counseling. Thank you very much.